What's going on, everybody? Private Benji here. And today we're going to switch things up a little bit. I'm going to do some World of Tanks gameplay with the Pershing and highlight another one of the T25 Pilot 1. Two very comparable tanks in the Tier 8 American side. Pershing being one of my personal favorites, along with the T25 Pilot 1 being the alternative besides using a Super Pershing. The T25 Pilot 1 does have slightly better ground resistance, but in every other aspect, the Pershing and the T25, for all intents and purposes, are the same. Now, this is my replay right here is actually very short. It's only about 4 minutes here. If you want to, go ahead and skip ahead if you don't want to see any more of Pershing replay, because this is just a regular tank that anybody can get up to, even without using premium, without having a premium account, which is what I did. I have not spent one dime on World Tanks yet, and I still got to Tier 8. I'm trying to grind from Tier 8 to Tier 9, though, let me tell you. I don't think I'll be there anytime soon. And there I go with my first kill on the Type 64. Pretty much a Hellcat with a, where is it? Yeah, it's a Hellcat turret on a M42 Duster chassis, as you will. That was kind of a Chinese mix there. So, during this replay, quite a bit of the times, it's actually, we kind of wolf pack here for the first, 2 minutes or so. As you can see, we're all, you know, taking our turns, firing our way at people, and that unfortunate Swedish tank there, getting blown to bits. He's out of the match. And of course I tracked the Comet, let this guy have the kill, and the Comet was smart enough to hit my turret, and I got hit by the GW Tiger P. Not a very good thing, but I went ahead and finished off the FV4202. I'm gonna hold off on my repair kit. It's, you know, it's a premium one. That's 20,000 credits. I can't just go throw 20,000 credits out the window. But somebody spotted the GW Tiger P, so guess where I'm going? I'm going back for a little bit of revenge. Revenge? I'm going back for some revenge on this son of a bitch. And boom! Okay, that was a little early. Of course, I get my revenge on the GW Tiger P. And as you guys can see, there's a little bit of drama going on in chat. The M40 artillery guy, he's so upset because they left an entire flank open, and of course, Hellcat says blocked. I'll type that out too. I'll put blocked, and there I go. I'm just gonna let him keep going because that guy's obviously upset about dying. Dude, you're an artillery player. Your left click gets worn out quicker than anything else. I go ahead and get my shot off onto that T-34-2 Chinese tank, and then fire at the IS. One of the things I do have on the tank is the stabilizer, which helps out tremendously, especially being a of course being a Pershing and being a very mobile tank. You definitely want to have the stabilizer on it. It helps out tremendously. So I'm gonna get a little bit of revenge on this T-34-3 after he knocked out my ammo rack, causing me to use my premium repair kit. That's 20,000 credits. And as you see, I also have the Raymer, so I was able to beat the reload on the T-34-2. And here's the slightly heavier brother of the Pershing, the T-26. Super Pershing, which has added armor on the front, but helps none whatsoever on the sides. So there we go. I'm up to 5 kills. Let's see if I can get that 6th kill. Maybe get myself a top gun on this one. And all that remains is that IS that I tracked earlier. Oh, there he is. 215 health. I could get him. And of course not. Thanks, RNG. You just tracked the damn tank. I should have had that kill, but I did not. So, going over the stats, I made 28,000 credits. 1185 base experience points, and of course I don't have premium account, but I did get the highest amount of damage on my team, 5 kills, and that's pretty much about it. You know, I still have to auto repair and auto resupply, so I actually ended up with only 17,339 for the credits. I made 13 out of 15 shots onto targets, with one not actually penetrating. That was that last, very last shot. So anyways, moving on to the T25 Pilot 1 here, provided by Firejax. Thank you so much, sir. I went ahead and I'm going to highlight him because he has an excellent game here. Now, one of the things you do want to notice on the T25 Pilot 1 is that its chassis, or its hull, is not actually the same as the Pershing. It actually has, looks like a Pershing turret on top of a T20 hull, which means, you know, with most typical American mediums, you're going to be able to work the ridge lines a lot better because most of them come with minus 10 degrees for gun depression. It's not as good as, what was it, the Dicker Max. The Dicker Max has minus 15. I think that's one of the best in the game, if I'm not mistaken. And those are really good for working the hills. But we're going to see Firejax go up here on the west, the east side of Erlenberg. He's going to come over to the blown up part of like the castle wall over here, and he's going to use some of that gun depression to his advantage, which I hope you guys will be able to, you know, take into account that that's one of the best things you do with a medium tank like this that has really good gun depression. So he's going off to the right here. There's already a Comet that's been spotted, but he's not spotted yet. So there he is, working the ridgeline a little bit. He sees the Comet. Comet didn't see him there for a second, but he gets the very first shot off onto him. Gets a good, makes him think twice a little bit. And as you know, the Comet does end up having kind of a trollish turret, just like the T-25 does. As you can see, he's already bounced one shot from the Comet. That's why you don't shoot the gun mainly on this thing. Unless you got a very high penetrating ammunition type, like especially like tier 9, tier 10 heavies do. He's going to continue pushing up, and he takes one shot from an invisible E-25. That's two shots onto him. And he loses his ammo rack on that. And of course, I don't blame him for wanting to repair that, because when the ammo rack gets hit on, you know, the Pershing or the T-25, it moves from around 4 to 5 seconds up to over 8 seconds, 9 seconds for a reload time, and that's very detrimental when you got a, you're supposed to have a pretty quick firing 90 millimeter gun. So he's working the ridgeline, maybe get over, get another shot off. There he goes, auto aims and hits him, and he bounces another shot from the Comet, and the Comet is done for. Now, let's see if we can get onto that pesky little E-25 to the right. Sneaky little booger. That's probably one of the few tank destroyers that I really want to buy when it comes back on sale. I've never had the opportunity or chance to get it. And he hits the Carnarvon, which has a very nice 84mm gun, if I'm not mistaken. Correct me if I'm wrong, of course. And he kind of derps that shot into the E-25, misses. And comes around, maybe, can he get the last kill? Yeah, he got the final kill on the shot onto the E-25, finishing him off. And he's probably back at his game menu, just raging at the moment. Probably because all of the rest of the E-25's team just basically evaporated on this side of the map. So if you guys haven't been paying attention, like I normally don't, the base is being captured by one tank at the moment, and they're already halfway through. So, what's the thing to do? Well, there's only one man for this job, and that's a guy in a T-25, realizing that they probably should. Oh, never mind. he tracked the 5916. Maybe get another shot off onto him. I believe that one actually went through. So with only a minute left, somebody needs to get on that cap to keep it from getting, from keeping the other team from winning. And as you can see on the west side of the map, his team is pretty much gone. Everybody's just dead over there. That was probably the FP4202, the Panther, 1375 Cromwell, and 12T Chaffee, which were all light tanks on that side of the map. Or probably one of the few reasons. And he kind of... he didn't actually penetrate the IS there, as you heard from the in-game voice there. And he makes sure the second one counts, though. Also got a little bit of spotting damage. Can he? Oh, nice shot on the Hellcat. Can he get a second shot onto him? Where'd that Hellcat go? I'm going to say no. But there is another Hellcat on the backside there. Or, no, I'm sorry. The M5916. ELC. Just kind of camping up there. And, of course, this shot goes high over him. Hey, you can't hit them all. Especially with such a low slung tank like that. Keeps his eye on the Hellcat there on the back corner, but he's not actually going to shoot at him. But there's this one, this 5916, who doesn't think he's spotted. He must not know that, you know, other tanks are going to come around. And being sneaky, sneaky, using the ridge line, Firejax goes ahead and starts pulling up onto the ridge. 5916 doesn't know what's going to come around the corner, and then be his third tank he's taken down for this match. And, oh, what does he have there? He spotted himself an Oni. Japanese heavy, slow moving, as like most of them. And somehow he actually makes it over the tank and gets a shot off into him. Can't get another. There he goes. Got two shots into him. So far he's up to 2,600 damage. Oni's making it way too easy for him to... Oh, I'm so sorry. That's actually the Oho. What am I thinking? Tier 7 Japanese heavy, and he gets taken out by the Luva. No. It's just the T20. It's just Firejax and the Luva, and the Luva's name is Ironic, because it's going to be ironic what's going to happen to him. Well, you got a big, slow, dumb, heavy driver. He's like, come to me, and you're going to see a little bit of drama here. Oh, sure. Go ahead. Go to him. See what happens. And he gets deleted out of the game by the M40. So... Tiger P, of course, spots him after he shoots his round there. And this is what it is. Firejax being alone against 5 enemy tanks. Now, can he win this? That's the thing. And, of course, Firejack's no moron. He's like, I come to you, I die too. Which works out for his favor, because he's got this nice ridgeline to work with, but he's not able to spot any of the other tanks on that are on the point right now. So he's got 30 seconds. Can he make it back in time to reset part of the cap? Well, he's awfully close, so I'm going to say yes. But can he see them? That's the other thing. Which way is he coming into them? They don't actually know. And he spots them. Gets a shot off onto the Tiger P. Of course, resets the cap and actually stops it. Oh, he deletes the Hellcat out of the game. And what are you doing, Tiger P? You don't shoot the turret. Don't shoot the turret, not the front. Because, you know, it can be trollish at times. Can he get him with this shot? No, of course not. It's not enough alpha damage. And, of course, Firejax kind of dipped into his... premium ammo there, just in case he had to shoot the front of the Tiger P, because 200 millimeters of armor there on the front plates. And he's not spotted at the moment. Oh, but he spots a Lorraine 155 artillery. And as you can see, there's that little window in the middle. If he would have missed that, he could have actually shot right through that and not even hit him. but he gets the second shot off, deletes him out of the game. So that leaves him with 6 kills, securing the top gun with 2 enemy tanks left to destroy, which is, you know, M40 dumb artillery left clicker, along with a Hellcat tank destroyer, which this guy in the Hellcat probably was playing to as good of strengths as he could. But he's still sitting on point. Firejax knows exactly where he's at. He knows he's over here. He was last spotted on to his right somewhere. But he hasn't been spotted in a while. And he shows up again. Can he get a shot off? Well, Firejax doesn't really want to wait around and figure out what the artillery is going to do to him. So he makes sure he gets, lets the 7 seconds go away. He turns around and books it out of there. He's got plenty of time to come back and reset the cap if need be, or sit on it. He just needs to pull away, get away enough that the Hellcat driver can't see him, and get back over to another area of the map. And of course, you know, lovely placed bushes will keep him concealed for the moment as he turns around, comes back in. Can he spot this Hellcat? Because I wonder if the Hellcat's even paying attention. Oh, and he gets spotted. I don't know if the Hellcat realizes it, but he took a big damage roll on that too. Which he depletes him out of his last high explosive round, which, you know, the high explosive definitely helped him out with that Hellcat. And of course the Lorraine 155 that he used before. So 2-1. Where's that artillery? We haven't really heard any shots come in from him. There was the Lorraine 155, and also when he took out the Lurva, or however you say the, I want to say low because I'm English and I'm American. I'm pretty sure I mispronounced that quite a bit. And did you see that tree knock over right there? Oh, M40, what are you doing? And he spots him. Does M40 get enough time to spin around? Oh yes, he does. Plenty of time. You don't want to be on the receiving end on that artillery, especially if you're at this close of range, because that's just a accident waiting to happen. So Firejax decides it's a good enough time now just to get away from him, and the Hellcat misses. And nice snapshot from Firejax onto the Hellcat. Can he finish him off here? Nah, it doesn't look like it. Well, he's not spotted anymore, so where'd that M40 go? Oh, there he is. Can he get a shot in on him? And he's detected, of course, because of proximity. Where's the Hellcat? Is the Hellcat going to come out and take a shot off into him? And he gets a shot into him. Of course, Hellcat ducks back into cover. He's playing a little bit of peekaboo. But the M40 thought it'd be a great idea, and he gets set on fire. That will definitely earn him the Arsonist achievement, or ribbon, as you may call it. And there he goes, Hellcat spotty. He's playing peekaboo. Can he get the shot? Can he get that shot off? Oh, he got the shot off. There he goes. He secured it. He won it for his team. Won it 5-1. So as you guys can see, he earned himself the Master Tank badge, which is the Ace Tanker, of course. He got himself the Radley Walters, along with the Kalibanov's Medal, which is standing against 5 enemies when he's the last tank on his team. He also got the Defender Medal for reducing the base by 70 points or more, High Caliber, Tanker Sniper, and of course, the Top Gun. Here you see he has at 5,800 damage, 1,792 in base experience. He goes ahead and beats out everybody else on his team, especially the next 4 players on his team in damage done. And of course, with a premium account, he walks away with a very healthy 112,363 credits, and times 2 for his first win of the day, 5,600 base experience. And out of his 36 shots fired, 31 hit and 27 direct, 27 penetrations, of course, and almost 2,000 of that was from a distance of over 300 meters. That's all I have for today, everybody. I appreciate you making it this far. If you like my content, don't forget to hit subscribe. If you also like the video, don't forget to hit like on the video. And if you didn't like it, hit dislike. Of course, you know, why would you want to do that? And I want to thank you again for stopping by, and I hope you all have a good one.
Peace.